Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Tommy Cam Field for a doubleheader tonight. Your Hancock County Hornets will be hosting Webster County. I'm not sure what both teams' records are. I know the Hornets have just come off a district defeat against Meade County, which I understand is probably one of the top two teams in the region. The way they hit the ball, I understand they've got decent pitching, pretty good 1-2. So looks like maybe Meade County and Muhlenberg County are the leaders in the region right now. Of course, Hancock County needs to worry about getting out of the district and making it to the region. What I've seen, Hancock and Breck are about even. So to go in as a 2 seed into the region would not be bad, just to get there and get some experience for next year for sure. Looks like for the Hornets tonight, leading off is going to be number 5, BP Roberts, playing center field. Batting second, number 13 on the hill, Tanner Singleton. Batting third at shortstop, Jacob White. Batting fourth at third base, JT Bell. Batting fifth at first base, Cameron White. Batting sixth, playing right field, number 1, Nathan Swihart. Batting seventh, behind the dish, number 22, Tyler Kratzer. Batting 8th, playing second base, number 19, Andrew Bloom. And batting 9th, playing left field, number 4, Wyatt Baker. Leading off for Webster County will be number 10, Galen Salazar. Salazar settles in. First pitch is strike by Singleton. I'm sorry, young man's name at the plate is Gabe Salazar. No ball is 1 strike. Tanner evens it up 1-1. I think these two teams may have sort of the same type of records this year. The Hornets have lost some players due to injuries. Ball up and in. 2 balls, 1 strike by Singleton. I think Singleton just needs to find the zone here early and get some ground balls. Don't try to overpower anybody. Nice pitch for a strike on the inner third right there. 2-2. So number 10 at the plate. Salazar has taken 4 pitches, hasn't taken a cut at any of them. Hits that ball through the 6-5 hole. Line drive. So Salazar leads off with the first cut. 2-2 count, single into left. Batting now for Webster County will be number 8, Clayton Buchanan. So runner on first. JT Bell in on the grass at third, so he must be expecting a bunt. They must know a little bit about this ball club. Tanner sails in. No bunt. Got a 2-ball right there. Tommy White turns it. Andrew Bloom couldn't get it out of the glove. Got the out at second, which you're supposed to do. Nice job getting the lead runner. Sometimes the ball just gets buried in the glove a little bit. I think this is Andrew's 2nd start at second base that I've seen him on our home field. I'm not sure if he started up against Meade County or not. At the plate now, number 23, Brendan Thompson for Webster County. Tanner checks the runner at first. Got a safe lead over there. 23 takes a hack, 1 on the outer third. No ball is 1 strike, 1 out, runner on first for Webster County. Tanner out of the stretch. Throws it in and beans him. The 23 draws a bag. Got runners on first and second, 1 out. Coming to the plate, a 4-hitter, Ethan Clayton. First baseman, one of the most most athletic kids I've seen come to play for Webster County. Look on the left side of the field, and Jacob and JT having a little conversation about who's going to do what. I think he's letting JT know if the ball's hit to him, he's probably going to take it to third. There's a pop-up, exactly what we need on the infield. Jacob White actually should be called infield fly, but umpire still hadn't moved, so didn't have to worry about it. It was caught anyway. So two outs, runners on first and second. Number two coming to the plate, Logan Erickson. So Tanner's hit a runner, give up one hit. Had a fielder's choice, possible double play ball. One thing I will say, Tanner just hit the outer third. Nice pitch right there. I don't believe these kids are going to reach that ball. One thing I noticed also, Andrew covering second, but he's going to have to break off that bag a little quicker and get to that hole. There's a lot of room between first and second right now. And this guy's definitely going to go to the right side, I believe. So no balls, two strikes. One foul ball and one called strike. I don't really understand this, but I'm sure there's some reason to this madness. Nice strike three. Good strikeout by Singleton. So in the top of the first, Webster County scores no runs on one hit, leaves two men on. For the Hornets, your leadoff will be BP Roberts, Tanner Singleton, and Jacob White. We're going to take a short break and recognize our Third Region Network sponsors. This is Rob McCormick Live. And Jacob White coming up on the hill for Webster County tonight. Looks like we've got number two, Logan Erickson. So I think Hornets put it in play. They ought to have a good chance to get on a bag. Here at Tommy Cowan Field, Webster County, of course, usually has a very solid baseball team. Like I said, I think they're rebuilding this year. Sort of like Hancock County. But kid on the hill drops down. He's throwing, not really submarine, but he's dropping down about three quarters, it looks like. We've had a legend from Hancock County come up in the booth. He'd probably like to pick up the other set of headphones. Coach Chris Pate coached here for years, last head coach to win the region. Talking about how he's got a young man that plays for him, that's his son, Ricky Lee, just mashing the ball. So we look forward to seeing him in the future. So coming to the plate now for Hancock County, number five, BP Roberts. I think I heard last week BP was batting about 327. BP is one of the four seniors on the team. somebody needs to let these umpires know it's going to be a doubleheader tonight, and we don't need to take 10 minutes between every inning or every half inning. BP settles in. Pitcher looks in, throws the fastball up. Count one ball, no strikes. Going into the bottom of the first here, folks. BP hits one right back to the pitcher. So, 1-3. Makes it pretty easy for the guy. Sees two pitches. Coming into the box right now, Tanner Singleton, number 13. First pitch hits a line drive in the 6-5 hole. Nice job handling hands on that. Coming to play with the runner on first, number 14, Jacob White. Jacob's been pretty hot. He was batting over the 400 clip the last time I read. And I'm Coach Mosby. I might be sending Singleton on the first pitch. Get him in scoring position. Pitcher makes a move for Webster County to first. Tanner gets back in plenty of time. I'd go and get in their step. Take the takes first pitch for a strike. Jacob settles in, and Tanner's gone. I'm not sure they had a hit and run on there. May have. No balls, two strikes on Jacob at the plate. Tanner at first. So Jacob settles back in. One that gets down. So two back-to-back singles by Singleton and White. Wasn't the hardest ball I've seen hit all year by Jacob White, but it's a line drive in the books. Coming to plate now, number 24, JT Bell. Batting in the four hole. Ball down and out, JT, take a look. One ball, no strikes. Runners on first and second for Hancock County. One out. And I tell you what, he walks into one. Left fielder doesn't have a chance. We're going to score one. It looks like Jacob White might beat Singleton to the plate. He's right on his toes. Nice job. Nice piece of hitting by JT Bell. Hit the bottom of the wall at about the 320 mark. Come to the plate for Hancock County, number 25, Cameron White. With JT Bell standing on second, I'd like to see Cameron walk into one right now. So stand up devil for JT Bell, ball up. Cameron lays off of it. We all know Cameron White has potential to walk right into one, folks. So Cameron yanks one down third baseline, about 10-foot foul. Gonna have to wait back. One ball, two strikes. Cameron White plate. JT Bell on second base. Haven't seen anything but a fastball thrown by this pitcher yet. And that'd be a good time to throw a hook, but that was one on outer third, and Cameron takes a hack at it. Strike three. So for the Hornets, they've got two runs, two outs, runner on second base, and at the plate now, number one, Nathan Swihart. So with Nathan Swihart at the plate, third baseman back deep, it wouldn't surprise me with two outs. Swihart doesn't lay one down third baseline. He takes a hack at one, foul ball. Nice cut. I'm still thinking, though, that as deep as that third baseman is, and with the speed Swihart has, he can lay one right down that third baseline and beat it out. And I think if you put the ball on the ground and make them make a play, some good things might happen. Swihart fouls one off down the first baseline. No balls, two strikes. So two outs, two strikes, no balls, and the Hornets have put two runs on, earned, in the bottom of the first. Swihart hits one decent to the second baseman. He fumbles it, and I think Swihart beats that out. So we've got an E4, Swihart standing on first, JT Bell on third. Coming to the plate, number 22, Tyler Kratzer. I think Kratzer's batting right at 300. So, I believe Swihart doesn't go on the first pitch. He'll definitely go on the second pitch. Probably one of our fastest kids we got on the team. There goes Swihart on the first pitch. They tried to throw him out, throw it in the center. Swihart's going to be going to third. JT Bell scores. So an E2 on the throw down to second. We've got a man on third, three runs. Number 22, Kratzer at the plate. So Kratzer's going to settle in with one ball, no strikes. Reaches out and slaps one foul, makes it one ball, one strike. So here's 22, Kratzer at the plate. Runner on third. Ball down. Two balls, one strike. Kratzer at the plate. We've got dreamers in the booth tonight with us, folks. I can tell you that. Kratzer just rips one foul down the left field line. He waited just a second. Y'all heard the song Dream Weavers. We've got them in the box with us tonight, I'm going to tell you. So anyway, at the plate, Kratzer, two balls, two strikes, two outs. Hits one hard to short. Shortstop picks it up, makes a throw. Gets the out, so the Hornets in the inning, putting three earned runs on the board. We're going to take a break. See you later.
Every dime of it.
I played until sitting there paid
and they played every dime.
Like a young team. So no ball is one strike. Hornets up 3-0. Here he takes a big cut. 0-2. Really, if I'm Singleton on the hill, I'm not wanting to strike everybody out. I'm wanting to get ground balls, save my arm, and complete the game. Buddy carries it on, and Gary did a nice job keeping his hands in, took the ball to right center. Good job by the right fielder for Hancock County. Nathan Swihart getting the ball in. Holds him to a single. At the plate now, number 55, batting in the 7 hole, Drake Villains. Drake, pretty good sized young man. Like I said, Hornets up 3-0 in the top of the 2nd now. Gary getting a pretty nice lead over there, like he's wanting to do something. Tanner looking in. I think he led off the last inning with allowed a single. We got the 4th. I'm going to tell you what, if that swipe tag's a little quicker, we might get this kid at first base. The throw got there in a hurry. Like he's going. No. Young man gets a nice bunt down. I gotta give number 55 credit. Nice bunt moving his runner to 2nd base. Puts it right down the 1st baseline. Coming to the plate now, number 14, Landon Black for Webster County. Looks like another young man. Webster County looks pretty young this year. Tanner, an 18-year-old junior on the hill. Cameron White playing in on the grass. Lefty here. We've had two lefties this inning. The leadoff lefty hit one. Or no, I'm sorry. He was a right-handed there. Ball gets away from the catcher, number 22, Kratzer. One ball, no strikes. Runner advances to 3rd base. Not sure this coach might not be putting a safety squeeze on. Looks like to me, got a little safety squeeze on here. We'll see, though. Nope, hits it right back up the middle. Bloom goes to make the play. Nice dig by White. Andrew made a nice job making the play on the ball. He just... He needs to realize he's got time and just rear back, take a step, and let it go. So with 2 outs, Webster County puts 1 on the board. At the plate now, number 7, Colton Nunn. Nice pitch there by Singleton. So number seven, none. At the plate for Webster County. No balls. One strike. Singleton delivers. Throws one down. Nice scoop by 22 Cratcher behind the dish. One ball, one strike. Hornets up 3-1. Top of the second. Hits one right back to Singleton. Singleton makes a play. Nice toss to first. So that's going to end the inning. For Webster County, they score one run on one hit, left one man on, or no man on. Folks, we're going to take a short break here for our third region network sponsors. Sports Network here, Rob McCormick. Umpires aren't getting any hurry to try to speed this game up any. They're letting these kids throw about 8, 9, 10 pitches between innings, and I guess they're wanting to earn their money tonight. I'm not sure because they're here for a doubleheader, whether they like it or not. Because I don't see a cloud in the sky that looks like rain. Now we're going to have a get-together on the mound. It's going to last another 30 seconds. Umpire at first, I don't know that he's moved a foot off that line the whole game. They're just not getting real excited. So Bloom settles into the box now after 5 minutes of the coin innings. Takes one up and out. One ball, no strikes. Andrew, a junior, done a lot of growing this year, has worked hard. Fouls one straight back. I believe that got a hold of somebody's car, and I believe it was mine.
Who was it?
Bloom
truck.
Wasn't mine then.
That way went to bed.
So Bloom at the plate, 1-1. Hits one into center, and he swelled up one. Burton's in a feather, and he's going two. Bloom's going to get the second stand-up double by Bloom. He burns the center fielder. That's the first ball he squared up on in the last couple games. And, I mean, I think Mom will be proud to watch this ball game tonight. Of course, prayers go out to the Bloom family. As Laura's out of town with her mother. And we hope good things happen. Pray for good things to happen. And Andrew just burnt the center fielder. Tommy White up here, I thought he was climbing out of the box. Bloom takes third on a pass ball, so what better time to squeeze? I mean, you know, we got the best bunter on the team. Third baseman. Not really in on the grass. He is playing about a step in. Now, third baseman creeps on in now. So, one ball, no strike. I'm not seeing this. I'm seeing this playing for a bigger inning. I think Baker wanted to hit himself in the head with his bat on that cut because the ball was up and in. He got a little disgusted. But that's why you get three strikes, son. You don't have to worry about that one. Shake it off and step back in and hit the next one. One thing I can tell you, though, Baker handles the bat well, and the ball hits the ground twice, ball down and out, two balls, one strike, he's going to make it to first base. Infield in for Webster County, so really, anything hit towards any gap is going to get through. White fouls one back, 2-2. Andrew Bloom on third base. White batting in the nine hole. Hornets running a straight nine tonight. All White needs to do is put this ball in play. Two balls, two strikes. Nice cut by White. Pitcher from Webster did a good job keeping the ball down. Coming to the plate for the Hornets, BP Roberts, number five, the leadoff. Hit one right back to the pitcher his first at bat. Like to see BP be a little bit more patient at the plate. Ball up. One ball, no strikes. BP settles back in. Pitcher not paying any attention to Andrew at third. He's getting a little walking lead. Ball down and out. 2-0. Right, you want to square one up right here. You're looking in one place and one place only. I don't understand Webster playing their infield in the second inning. 3-0, he's red light all the way, I'd say, because you got two guys coming up that back-to-back hit singles. So BP's definitely on the red light 3-0 right here, I think. And that's ball four. BP, nice at bat. Webster still looks like they're backing their middle infield up. At the plate now for Hancock County, number 13, Tanner Singleton. Tanner ripped one in the 6-5 gap. His last at bat, waited back and hit a line drive about head high for a single. Say I'm sending BP on the first pitch right here, folks. And he does. Third baseman throws it to third. One ball, no strikes. So Tanner at the plate, one ball, no strikes, runners on second and third. Webster brings their infield in again, and Tanner just rips it, and they field playing back. Shortstop makes that play. Ball gets by the left fielder, so that's two RBIs for Singleton, and he gets into second base on a single and an error on the left fielder for a double. Nice job of base running by the Hornets. So at the plate now with a runner on second base is number 14, Jacob White. Jacob's one for one for the night with a single. Part of the day that's the hardest part of the day to catch a fly ball in the outfield at Basswood Park, Tommy Cown Field. Jacob, nice look there on one inside. So one out, Hornets put two on the board, and Jacob rips one in the 6-5 hole. Coach Mosby's bringing Singleton home. So rip single for White down the third baseline. RBI, I believe that's... I don't think he got an RBI the first inning. I think he just had a stand-up single. So Hornets have put three on the board so far in the bottom of the second. One out, and JT Bell up, and JT Bell hit the bottom of the wall last inning. Looks like like Jacob White's getting a play at lead out there. He may be going on a pitch here. Pitcher's awful worried about it. Infield hadn't been playing in while ago on that Tanner Singleton ball. Ball had been hit straight to the shortstop. White goes on the first pitch, hit and run, I guess. Nice job by the center fielder to get the ball in. Good piece of hitting by JT Bell. JT Bell, 2-for-2 tonight. Coming to the plate now, number 25, Cameron White. Cameron had a couple of nice cuts his last at bat. Pitcher ended up getting him on one on the outer third. He told something about numbers in. Cameron gets under one. It's a high pop up on the infield. Infield fly rule, and they just let it drop. Huh. Well,
all you can say.
Two outs, and at the plate now for Hancock County, number one, Nathan Swihart. Runners on first and second. Score 6-1. Hornets in the bottom of the third, and we're wanting to add a couple more. Swihart takes a big hack. So we've got no balls, one strike, two outs, runners on first and second, and Swihart at the plate. Just got a text message from Bubba Shound saying that we needed to go live. You can't hear anything. Can't help it, Bubba. They're not paying me the kind of money they paid you. So we got to record it and download it later. So at the plate, two balls, one strike to Nathan Swihart. One to Swihart, runs on first and second, two outs, 6-1, Hornets are on top, and like I said, we're looking to add some runs to this inning. So, Swihart takes one on ball four, so he ought to get double the bases. Ball four gets hit by pitch. So base is juice now, and number 22, the catcher, Tyler Kratzer, comes to play. Coach is going out from Webster County to have a talk with his pitcher, so we're going to take a short break here, folks, and let our Third Region Sports Network sponsors get a little record. About the play of the game that we're a little confused about, but you know, strange things happen on the baseball field. Anyway, Kratzer hits one up the middle of the second baseman, juggles it a little bit, and E4, Hornets put a run across the board, so makes us 7-1 in the bottom of the second, and I think our leadoff, Bloom, is back up to the plate. He led off the inning with a double that just flat burnt the center fielder. And he's beefed up. He's done ripped one down the first baseline, but the first baseman made a nice play on him. Nice piece of hitting. So the Hornets score 4 in the bottom of the second. Score 7-1, Hancock County. We're going to take a short break here, folks, and recognize our Third Region Sports Network sponsors. Welcome back to Tommy Cam Field, folks. Number 10 at the plate for their leadoff, Gabe Salazar. Led off the last, or the top of the first with a base hit. I think he blocked four pitches and was 2-2 in the count. Has a strike there. No ball, one strike. Hornets are up 7-1 in the bottom of the second. Playing the top of the third right now. Webster County to play. Tanner Sampson throws a nice deuce. Strike two. So no balls, two strikes. No outs. Leadoff up for Webster County. Senator Rare's back. Lets it go up. I don't think the kid really wanted to take a hack at that. That ball was up a little bit. So it's one out on three pitches. Now to play number eight. Clayton Buchanan for Webster County was one out. Umpire's been pretty generous tonight, isn't he, Tommy?
Being very generous on that outside, but yeah, I
tell you. I'm Singleton. I'm going to live out there because they can't reach it. Huh. That's two huhs tonight, Tommy.
Wow.
And if he doesn't take a hack, that ball, it hits him. So, no balls, two strikes. I think number eight was just trying to protect his leg or something. So the Hornets up 7-1. Eight's making a tough battle now for Singleton. No ball, two strikes. I believe Deuce right here would get him. What do you think, Tommy?
Yeah.
I got Tommy White up here in the booth. He's on one that they didn't sit with me, so. And he flares one down the right field line, and he got her down, and he got held to a single there by the right fielder, number one, Nathan Swihart. Let's play now for Webster County, number 23, Brandon Thompson. Number 23 got hit by a pitch on the first pitch, his last at bat. Put runners on first and second. Well, Tanner's getting about a ball on the inside and about 4 inches on the outside, so. Yeah, it is, definitely. You better be taking hacks. And I tell you what, he just ripped one down the left field line, and outfielder's doing a good job keeping the ball in front of him, holding these guys to singles, but if I'm Tanner, I'm going to stay away from the middle of the plate. I'm throwing in and out. You know, I hadn't seen him throw very many deuces tonight either, Tommy.
No.
So, got our number five. Ethan Clayton at the plate for Webster County. Batting in the four hole. They're going to send a runner. Wyatt Baker comes up, makes a throw. Catcher did a nice job knocking the ball down. Nice toss in. Tanner's staying with the fastball. I believe I'd mix it up a little bit because they're sitting on dead red. Tanner's got a pretty good breaking ball. So, Webster County's got one on the board with one out. Runners on first and second, and their number five man to play. Tanner looks in. Andrew Bloom holding the runner at second. not sure, folks, but this is one of the slowest played games I think I've seen all year. Kind of throws one down and out. Two balls, one strike, or no strikes, one out. Runners on first and second for Webster. I'm sure Hancock would like to put several on the board next inning and hold these Webster County team to two runs and try to get this one over in five. So two balls, one strike on the batter. Runners on first and second. Hornets up 7-2 with one out. We got Andrew Boone playing up the middle, leaving a pretty big hole on the right side of the infield. And that's where he goes. And White makes a play. Nice job fielding the line drive. He's going to go back to first and try to double him up and then decide to try to get the guy at second. So two outs. Batter at the plate for Webster County, number 12, Thomas Geary. Geary's a name you hear from Grayson County quite a bit. And they could always play the game. So one ball, no strikes. Singleton's pitch count's up pretty good, really, through three. Keeping the ball right around the zone most of the time. So two balls, no strikes, two outs. Runners on first and second for Webster County. Gary hits fly ball to center field. BP Roberts camps out under it. Long fly ball, can of corn. So that's three outs. Hornets still up 7-2 going into the bottom of the second, or bottom of the third. Baseman is, and he's playing in a little bit, but Baker tries to lay one down, bunts it foul. No balls, one strike. This is one right here with the third baseman playing in. If I'm Baker, I'm taking it with me to first base because first baseman is not going to be able to come in and get it. So no balls, one strike, no outs. Baker's the leadoff for the Hornets. We're up 7-2 in the bottom of the third. Baker does make the attempt. So he's in the hole now. No balls, two strikes. Good bunter, always fun, old two, though. No, he hits one deep to right. Right fielder playing in just perfect depth. He hits the ball square, though. So now leadoff for the Hornets, number five, BP Roberts. He's hit one back to the pitcher for a 1-3 and walked his last at bat. BP show a little patience up here, draw a bag, and get to our 2-3 hole. BP's going to try to lay one down. Peter got that down. I think it's been right back to the pitcher. Looks like to me the way it fouled straight back. Third baseman playing in. No balls, two strikes. Umpire is very generous tonight, as me and Tommy White were talking earlier between innings. Comes and makes a play on the first baseline. High pop up by BP. Coming to the plate now for the Hornets, number 13, Tanner Singleton. I believe Tanner's 2 for 2, 2 singles. Ended up stretching the last one into a double on the error on left fielder. Hit the ball hard. He squared both pitches up. He's hit hard. Ball up. One ball, no strikes. Tanner settles in. Takes a pitch. Nice job right there by Singleton. Draw a bag.
Usually don't want to hit the pitcher.
No. Not a good idea. Comment was made up here in the box. You usually don't want to hit the pitcher, and I'd say he's absolutely correct. If I'm going to hit somebody, it's not going to be him. So I wouldn't be surprised right now if we don't steal on first pitch, get a runner in scoring position, and Jacob White at the plate, because it wouldn't hurt at all either way. Gives a chance to score a run, or Jacob White leading off the next inning. White takes one down now. Doesn't look like Singleton was moving, so maybe we're playing a little bit conservative here. Jacob trying to go to the right side. He does have a lot of room down that right field line. Anything he hits down that line, he'll be standing on third base because it's going to get to the fence. Right fielder's giving him about 50 foot off the line. Ball up. Singleton takes second on the steal, gets in scoring position, two balls, one strike. And White does go to right field. It's like I said, the right fielder's going to have to cover a lot of ground, and he's going to be standing on second easy. So stand up double by White, RBI, good job right there, good piece of hitting. I'd like to see him throw that ball more instead of get under it, but he did put the ball where it needed to be hit. So White, 3 for 3 tonight, 2 singles and a double. Singleton, 2 for 2, and now to play JT Bells, who's actually squared 2 balls up well. Didn't get anything out of his last one, but he got a lot out of that first one. So the Hornets up 8-2 in the bottom of the third, 2 outs. JT Bell swung out of his socks, wanted to hit that one about 2 miles. Fleet coach said, hey, just stay within yourself. You got the power there, son. JT's put on some mass this year. So runner on second, Jacob White. JT fouls a curveball off, and that's about the only third curveball I've seen thrown tonight by both pitchers. So JT Bell at the plate, no balls, 2 strikes. Just get all he wanted out there. And JT knuckles one, and I believe that ball might get down. No, shortstop nice makes play. A nice play. Nice play by the shortstop, Webster County. So the Hornets put one on the board. They're up 8-2 in the bottom of the third. We're going to take a quick break here for our Third Region Sports Network sponsors to get some recognition. This is Ray. Goes back and picks up the ball and decides, oh, we'll just keep using this one. So no balls, 1 strike. Tanner delivers to the plate, hits the ball hard to second. Bloom does a nice job, picks it up, makes a nice toss to first. Good job, Andrew Bloom. Nice pitch by Tanner. So now at the plate for Webster County, number 7, batting in the 9-hole, Colton Nunn. Be nice to get out of an inning clean. Nobody on base. Short pitch count in this inning. Ball hitting the right. Bloom comes over, makes a great attempt to the ball. single by the number 9 hitter, number 7 Nunn, batting now number 10 Gabe Salazar. So Salazar to play to lead off, Singleton on the hill. Ball careens off the hill, and Jacob White makes a nice play on a ball that takes a funny kick off the hill. So that's the third out of the inning. Webster puts none on the board in the fourth, so the Hornets going into the bottom of the fourth, up 8-2. And I'm sure they'd like to put about 4 runs on the board and hold Webster County to 0 in the top of the fifth, and make this a 10-run game and end it early. Folks, we're going to let our third region sports now. Safety run and shut Webster County down in the top of the fifth and end this thing. 2 balls, no strikes. White just needs to be patient. Both teams stayed with their same pitchers. Be nice to end this one in 5. White takes one out. 3-0. I would have to say he's red light here right now. Looks like Mike gave him green light though. Unless that's changed over the years. Wouldn't have mattered. Ball down the dirt. So White draws a walk. Standing on first base. At the plate now, number 1, Swihart. Swihart very capable of laying the bunt down. Third baseman is playing back a little bit, but I'd take it with me. Swihart hits one into center, and center fielder's coming in hard and makes a nice play on the ball. Shortstop never even made an attempt. Second baseman went out. Fly ball to center, and the center fielder made a great play on the ball. At the plate now, number 22, Kratzer, our catcher. Ball down now. Raymond White on first base. Cratcher at the plate. Cratcher's got some strength in them arms. He keeps his hands in. Takes a hack at that ball. One ball, one strike. So Cratcher moving all the way to the front of the box. And he knuckles one down the first baseline. And he's called out on the tag. Their first baseman interfered really with his own player, the pitcher going to make the play. I'm not sure there was a tag made, and that could have been an appeal of the plate, but from where our infield umpire was standing. At the plate now, Bloom, and he swelled up on his first, and Bloom's decided, I'm hitting the ball. Third baseman goes back on a pop-up, makes a play. So the Hornets don't scratch any across on a leadoff walk by White. So the score 8-2 in the bottom of the fourth, going to the top of the fifth, folks. And we're going to give our Third Region Sports Network sponsors some recognition. We'll be back. Clayton Buchanan, the number two hole hitter. Simpson throws a strike in, no ball, one strike. Hornets up 8-2. Joe Crossley's probably going to get on me. I haven't done a very good job of keeping up with the scores. Young man at the plate fouls one off. No balls, two strikes.
Do what, John? Who's water heater? Don't make a bunch of money.
So 0-2. One ball, two strikes. Batter takes a good look at that pitch. Tanner looks in. Throws the ball down and out. Wild pitch. 2-2. So the Hornets up 8-2 in the top of the fifth. Mm-hmm. Batter gets it all the way back. the full count. Done a nice job of battling here to play. Singleton throws one down the middle right there and gets it all. Nice job of fielding the ball. If he doesn't catch that ball, he's hurt. Nice job of playing your position, pitcher. Walk out there and talk to your third baseman in a second. I'm not sure that ball didn't get in on his belly. What do you think, Tommy? Nice play by Singleton, though. It's a good thing he's got quick hands. So let's play now for Webster County, number 23, Brandon Thompson. Singleton throws a deuce down the dirt. One ball, no strikes. It's only about the second or third deuce I've seen Singleton throw tonight, but this kid did hit a leadoff fastball his last at bat. First single. Two balls, no strikes. Ball up and in, 3-0. Singleton's pitch count's getting up pretty good, I'd have to think. He's got to be somewhere around 75. I'm guessing 75 pitches. Does the right thing right there. The batter squares the bunt on three balls, no strikes, and Singleton just throws it right down the middle. Up 8-2. It's another, well, that's been a strike about 10 minutes ago, 5 minutes ago.
Yeah.
Might be the first walk of the game I've seen for Webster County.
I believe it is.
So at the plate now for Webster County, number 5, Ethan Clayton. Runner on first base, one out on a squared line drive, hit right back at our pitcher, Tanner Singleton. Made a nice play. So runner on first, number 5 at the plate, Ethan Clayton, batting in the 5 hole. Or no, he's batting in the 4 hole. Tanner throws one down. So one ball, no strike, it's one out. Looks at his runner, delivers to the plate, 1-1, I'm not sure that pitch was much different than the pitch he just called a ball. Makes it tough at the plate on a batter when you get two pitches back to back and one's a ball and one's a strike. That pitcher's in the same exact place and really it's a ball, but pitcher's got it, or the batter's got to take a hack at it. So one ball, two strikes, and, you know, if I'm Tanner, that's where I'm going to live, is right there at chin high. Runner on first for Webster County. He throws the deuce. He cannot give up. The runner's out. The batter's out. The runner can't advance, but since first base is occupied, he cannot go. So at the plate now for Webster County, number 2, Logan Erickson. So with a runner on second base, two outs, Erickson at the plate. Something hits a spot there. No balls, one strike. Ball hit right back Singleton. He's done a nice job of saying he just takes it himself and tags him. So for Webster County, they score no runs, left one man on. Hornets going into the bottom of the fifth are leading 8-2. We'll be back with you shortly, folks. We're going to take a break and let our Third Region Sports Network sponsors get a little out. Tries to lay the bunt down third baseline. Ball goes foul. No ball is one strike on Baker. Glad to see Baker back on the field. He had a very, devastating collision in right field a few games ago. And I think he had a few days rest and got back out there. So the man's showing some toughness. And he hits one. Hit. Nice base hit. Baker through the 3-4 hole. Good piece of hitting right there by Baker. So Baker leads off the bottom of the fifth with a base hit single. At the plate now, number five, BP Roberts, our leadoff. Be a good time to put four on the board, Tommy.
It would be a great time.
We've got leadoff, and our next two guys up have... I think they're five for five for the game, and Tanner Singleton got hit by Pitt. BP tries to lay down a bunt. No balls, one strike. I'm playing for a crooked number this inning.
I
don't believe I'd be playing small ball, but say those two men out there know a little bit more about than I do, so Baker gets back to first base on pitcher trying to pick him. No ball is one strike. And BP definitely has the capability of driving a baseball. Ball gets out foul. No ball is two strikes on BP. That hit something pretty hard. So 0-2, runner on first, no outs. Hornets up 8-2 in the bottom of the fifth. And like I said, I'd like to see two runs get on, or two people get on base. Nice piece of hitting there by BP. He stepped into one, and that ball's deep. He's going two. They're scoring Baker. Nice piece of base running by Baker. BP stepped into one and hit that ball hard into the right center gap. Center fielder almost made a great play on that ball.
Yeah, he did. Covered a lot of ground. Yes, he did.
So at the plate now, 2-for-2 for the night. Tanner Singleton Got hit by a pitch his last at bat. Got a runner on second. Score now 9-2, the Hornets. Tanner settles in. And I'm not sure he didn't get hit by that pitch, but maybe not. Maybe I just saw his shirt move. So one ball, no strikes. Runner on second on a BP double. Tanner's nice set of hands there. Good cut. One ball, one strike. Tanner just needs to do what he's been doing with it. Let his hands drive the ball, give him a line drive. A lot of gap in right center. Nice job by the catcher knocking the ball down. Two balls, one strike. I see a lot of green between right and center. Drive one that way. He hits the ball hard down the left field line. Just foul. Two balls, two strikes. Singleton at the plate, 2-for-2 for the night. Runner on second base, and the Hornets up 9-2. I'd see Tanner get on any way he can right now. Does a nice job fouling the curveball off. Very nice job. Inside out, flares it up into the stand. Good little crowd here for the Hornets tonight. So full count on Tanner. I'll be looking dead red. Of course, he's got a guard to play, though. As umpire's known, he's going to give him some room. So, but no, that ball's down and in. Nice job drawing the bag by Singleton. So runners on first and second, no outs. Jacob White coming to the plate for the Hornets, 3-for-3. A double and two singles. And he really hadn't put a charge into one yet. That'd be a good time for him to put charge into one about 320 over this left field wall and end this thing. Wouldn't hurt my feelings a bit. And I think he got the big watermelon look there, and he pops one up down first base, and the first baseman gives him an extra jam. That's unusual for Jacob. That ball was actually up and out for him to take a hack at that pitch. Jacob's usually a very disciplined hitter at the plate. Right fielder's not giving him that line this as much of it this inning like he did last inning. Jacob settles in, open stance, gets back closed, fouls the ball off, 0-2, starts out the same count just like Singleton did his last at bat. And Jacob's batting over the 400 clip. I'm not sure he's not above 425. He's one down now. Both runners are moving, so now he's got two runners in scoring position. Catcher just tries to throw the ball to third. Run comes in. BP's Roberts scores on an overthrow to third. So now White at the plate. One ball, two strikes. Singleton at third. Just needs to do his job here. I'd really like to see him drive a ball. One ball, two strikes. Hits one right up the middle. Another single. White perfect for the night. Three singles and two and a double. So the score 11-2. The Hornets. One more run. We can end this thing. And I'm sending White on the first pitch. I'd say he is going. Yes, he is. Catcher gets a good ball to throw down. He gets him out. Nice toss by the catcher.
Nice toss.
Second baseman handled the ball. White got a good jump. at the plate, JT Bell. I mean, I think that's a good call, but, you know, catcher made a nice toss, got a perfect pitch to throw down. The ball was on his right side, and all he had to do was bring it up and throw it. So score 11-2, one out, one ball, one strike. Ball up on JT, two balls, one strike. JT settles in, one out, ball down, 2-1, 3-1. I'm JT, I'm looking for one pitch and one pitch only, and that's one I can hit deep. Good eye right there. Ball 4, JT draws the bag. Coming to the plate now, Cameron White, number 25. Hornets up 11-2. Really would like to see them scratch one across and end this thing. Ball out. Umpire calls a strike there. It's another one of them huzz. One ball, one strike. Wasn't a whole lot of difference in them two pitches, other than the other one was about 2 foot outside of that. JT comes back in the first, standing up. White can always walk into one. I think he's either got 4 or 5 home runs on the year. 2 balls, 1 strike. I know I saw him hit one against Forest Park, I believe. Pitcher threw a nice little deuce there, 2-2. That pitcher, I'm going to take a read on that. What do you think, Tommy? And Cameron able to get the ball down. Got a runner on third base. E5 on the throw across the field. Throws it up the line a little bit. Makes it very tough on the first baseman. So one Swihart at the plate. JT Bell at third base. I don't know about the squeeze right here. Really, I'm not sure why Webster County's not playing in. They played in the early innings, down 3-1, with just a runner on third. So, Swihart takes a hack, no ball, one strike. Where's that third baseman's playing?
Third baseman or first.
I got to lay this ball down and end this game. I mean, ball down in. One ball, one strike. Bottom of the fifth. Swihart hit the plate. Blair's one foul down the left field line. I'd like to see him just get something in the air deep into the outfield. Swihart settles in. 1 ball, 2 strikes. He can still bunt that ball down his first baseline between the pitcher and takes a hack at one down and out. So makes 2 outs for the Hornets with runners on second and third, and coming to the plate, number 22, Kratzer. Hornets up 9 with 2 outs. Kratzer hits a pop-up, and the right fielder, the second baseman, one's going to have to get to it, and the second baseman makes a play. So the Hornets had a shot there to end this ball game and didn't take advantage of it, so we're going into the top of the sixth, up 11-2. We're going to give our Third Region Sports Network sponsors a chance for a little recognition. Batter to play for Webster County is number 12, Thomas Geary. Two balls, no strikes. Hornets up 11-2. Had a chance to end it the last inning. And to be honest with you, I've witnessed games like this over at Tell City one year to where we had a team down 11-2 in the bottom of the fifth, and they came back and beat us 12-11. Sivertson throws a strike in there. Three balls, one strike in the top of the sixth. Hits the ball right back to Singleton. Singleton's, that's three outs in the last four Singleton's made himself. Playing his position well. So at the plate now, number 55, Drake Villains, and he's laid down a good bunt the game, and he's hit a sharp ball down to third base that JT Bell made a nice play on. And as Tommy White said, for a big man, got down the line very well his last stroke he took. So at the plate, 55 with one out. And he lays one down the right field, and it gets fouled by about 10 feet. Can't really get a read on him because he's ripped one down third and laid the bunt down. Handles back pretty well. One ball, one strike. Two balls, one strike. One out for Webster County. Singleton throws it. What looked like to me a pretty nice pitch because 55's right on top of the plate. 3-1 for the Webster County with one out. Hornets up 11-2. 55 draws the bag. Batting now for Webster County, number 14, Landon Black. Like me, the coach is going to walk in and has a pinch runner going in. Number 32, pinch running, Brandon Kotzman for Webster County. Folks, I'm sorry for all the dead time in this game, but I don't really know what to say. Umpires have sort of drug this thing along. So we've got one out, runner on first for Webster County. Hornets up 11-2. Had a chance to end at the last inning. Singleton throws a pretty nice pitch in. One ball, no strikes. Pop up on the infield. Andrew Bloom fields it. Nice job, Andrew. Played a strong defensive game. That's two outs. At the plate now for Webster County, number seven, Colton Nunn. And Colton's done a pretty nice job hitting the baseball tonight. I think he might be one for two. He just put a charge into that baseball. Deep, White Baker's on him. White gets the ball back in.
He likes about 5 foot having rolled
the fence. Yes, he did. At the plate now, the leadoff for Webster County, number 10, Gabe Salazar. Runners on second and third for Webster County. Two outs. Hornets up 11-2. And their lead off at the plate. I know he hit a single. There's a nice deuce. He hit a single his first at bat. I think he struck out his second at bat. Tanner does throw a nice deuce there. Comes back up with another one, and that's a hard play to make. You're not going to make that play. So Webster County scratches a run across on a swinging bunt down third baseline, and really there's nobody. I mean, you can't even make a play on that ball. So Webster County puts another run on the board. Hornets up 11-3. Runners on first and third. Number 8 at the plate for Webster County, their two-hole hitter, Clayton Buchanan. Folks, he's going through the signals down at third base. One ball, one strike on the batter. Swinging bunts always kill you. Because you never know. I mean, nobody could have made a play on that ball. Oh, and they've got him picked. Run scores, makes it 11-4. Got the gentleman trying to steal second. Folks, we're going to take a break here and let our Third Region Sports Network sponsors get a little recognition. Hornets going into the bottom of the sixth, up 11-4. Andrew Bloom leading off, and he's put a charge in the ball tonight, and he hits another ball hard up the middle, and I believe that may get him there. He beats out the throw, and the umpire might have made. Well, I'm not allowed to comment on here, I've been told, so I'm not. But Bloom's standing two steps after first base and gets called out, so I'm not. Anybody that watches this, well, you can't see first base, so you're not going to be able to say it. So at the plate now, number four, Baker, and Baker's put a charge in a ball or two tonight. Baker takes a cut, fouls it down, foul to the right side. No balls, one strike, one out. Ball down and out. Number two for Webster County, thrown the whole game, just like Singleton has for us. We do have Jacob White warming up out in the bullpen, it looks like. Baker takes a hack at one up and in. One ball, two strikes. White had a very nice base hit his last at bat between the 3-4 hole. Ball up. Two balls, two strikes. Yeah, he's got to be at 90 plus. Ball down, 3-2. And I'm not sure, by the way, the umpire was sort of faced up. If that catcher catches that, that may have been strike three. So Baker draws a walk, nice at bat. Baker on first. Leadoff BP Roberts coming to the plate. Number five, he hit one hard in the right center gap his last at bat for a stand-up double. So BP steps up. Pitcher's a little crafty out there. He just turns and throws at will. I mean, he. BP hits one into center, but I don't believe that ball will get down. That center fielder's made some nice plays tonight for Webster County. He tracks the ball very well. So with a runner on first, two outs, Singleton coming to the plate. I believe Tanner's also, I think Tanner's 2-for-2 with a walk and a hit by pitch. So if we're going to score three, we're in the position right now in our lineup to do it. We've got Baker on first. Singleton at the plate. With White in the hole. Tanner hits one, fly ball to center field, and I believe that's going to end the inning. So the Hornets don't put anything on the board in the bottom of the sixth. Score 11-4, Hancock County going into the top of the seventh. We'll be back to you in 5 seconds, or in 55 seconds. 7th, folks. Webster County down 11-4. Number 8 at the plate for Webster County. Clayton Buchanan, their number 2 hole hitter. 0-1, fouls it back. Singleton comes back to the hill, and I know he's at 90-plus. Pitch right there is a strike in the first 5 innings. 1 ball, 1 strike. Tanner throwing a nice ball game. Ball hit in the center field pretty well. BP Roberts camped out right under it. BP Roberts, I tell you what, he's played a lot of utility positions, and he's, I've not seen him play one that he hasn't done a pretty good job at. So with one out, number 3 hole hitter, number 23, Brendan Thompson at the plate. Singleton throws the deuce. Ball hit to Cameron White at first. Singleton covers. Nice job. Good play there by the first baseman and the pitcher. So 2 outs, number 5 at the plate, their number 4 hole hitter, Ethan Clayton. Hadn't done a whole lot to us tonight. We could end this thing right now. The young man wanted a timeout and didn't get it from the umpire. Umpire didn't grant it to him. Tanner throws a nice hook in there to him. And then backs it up. That's a foul ball off his foot. Umpire did make a good call on that. No balls, 2 strikes. Reminds me of T-ball. Nice pitch here by Singleton. I wasn't referring to the players, folks. So 1 ball, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Number 4 hole hitter at the plate. Tanner throws his hook. 2-2. I'd like to see a ground ball to second base and get this thing over right now. Full count on the batter. Batter started out 0-2. He's done a nice job of fighting back.
Uh-oh.
I'd say that ball's out of this ballpark. It just left it. So number 5, their number 4 hitter, hadn't done a whole lot tonight, but that right there put a charge into him. He hit that ball well. That ball was hit well. Of course, it was up in the zone. He had fought back to a good count, got the full count. He'd been behind the count, and he was looking dead red.
Yep.
And he stepped right into it and hit a line drive out, oh, I'd say about 320. So coming to the plate now for Webster County, the pitcher, number 2, Logan Erickson. Hornets up 11-5. Had a chance to end it early, and just didn't quite get it done. Singleton's got to be 1 ball, 1 strike on the batter. He's got to be pushing 100 on his pitch count. 5 runs scored, several base runners. Nice pitch right there. 1 ball, 2 strikes. I say we just go get him right here and end this thing. But every time I say that, they end up getting a base hit. Strike three. Nice ball game by the Hornets. They beat Webster County 11-5. Didn't need their bottom of the seventh inning to bat. Sington throws a nice game. I'm sure he's wore out. He went the entire game. Hornets played a clean game. No errors. Webster County had maybe three or four errors, but folks, we're going to play two here tonight. So this is Rob McCormick, and I'm going to fire off our ads and let our sponsors have a little more recognition tonight. We want to thank our Third Region Sports sponsors, because without them, we couldn't be doing this. They do a wonderful job. So this has been Rob McCormick, and it's been enjoyable.